Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the Giving Game series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to talk about the law of attraction for the musical artist, for the music producer. Now we described this earlier. If you were paying attention and had this higher understanding, you'd understand that I have already explained the law of attraction. But let me reiterate some things and kind of go over some other principles that you need to understand about the universe. So firstly, I've drawn a nice diagram to pre-prep. Okay, I'm not sure how this is going to show up on your screen, but I'm assuming it looks right. So firstly, let's talk about the law of gender. We're not talking about sexual gender. We're not talking about body part gender. We're talking about spiritual gender. And by that, I mean receiving and giving. There's a masculine energy called giving. There's a feminine energy called receiving. Now, we all have to be both at some level. Okay, if you only gave knowledge all the time, you'd have nothing to give. You'd run out of things to give. Therefore, you'd have to receive knowledge at some point in order to give more knowledge. So we both have a masculine, a giving part, and we both have a feminine part, a receiving part. Now that can be in the form of your body, can be in the form of your mind, the form of your spirit, whatever. Everything has a masculine and feminine thing to it, a giving and receiving thing to it. Now imagine this. Now I know we're in the music world. So imagine a TRS cable or a patch cable, the things you plug into your audio interface. For example, when you play guitar, you plug in a patch cable, you plug that into your audio interface. That cable, TRS or balance, whatever type of cable it is, there's a masculine side which has a thing to it. The reason they call it masculine is also because it, you know, it looks like the phallus or whatever in the masculine physical form. So it goes in things, okay? It's giving things to other things. Now, the feminine side of the cables receive the thing. So there's a giver of the thing and there's a receiver of the thing. So the thing, you know, the giver is the masculine portion. The receiver is the feminine portion. Now, here's the mistake a lot of producers make. I've seen this everywhere. It's not just in music. Models even do it. You're targeting the wrong audience, okay? So here's what you're doing. Energetically speaking. So for example, your producer trying to sell another producer beats, and the producer is not looking for beats. Therefore, you're a giver trying to give to a giver. And we all know that opposites repel. We all know that opposites attract and similarities repel. So for example, imagine you are the north side of a magnet. You're trying to talk to another north side of the magnet, a producer who doesn't want beats. They're not in the market for beats. Now, some producers do buy beats. That's not the gist of this whole point. The gist is that you're trying to sell something to somebody who does not want it and is not looking for it. Therefore, they're not receiving the signal or the energy flow that you're trying to give. So you repel each other, okay? Because you're both trying to do the same thing without trying to accept or receive that thing. So you're repelling each other. There's chaos. There's repulsion. You're going to go in the complete opposite directions. Now, what happens if a producer talks to an artist and they're trying to sell beats? Now, the artist is going to be more receptive, so they're going to want to receive. So there's a masculine energy of that situation, which is the producer in this case trying to sell beats. They're the masculine. The artist in that case is the feminine energy. They're receiving. Now, in the first scenario, there's a producer trying to sell beats and another producer trying to sell beats as well. They're not looking for beats. So you have two masculine energies both trying to give, and they repulse, and that's why. So a lot of people are mismatching their audience. They're trying to give to people who do not want to receive what you have to offer. That's the problem. You're trying to give to people who do not want to receive your message, your content, your value. So you need to weed those people out initially. Understand who does not receive you well. And that's why there's a biblical principle about teaching parables. Some will understand it, some won't. When I plant these seeds of teachings to you, some will have those seeds go into the ground. It will grow up, it will sprout, and be a beautiful plant. Those are the people who receive the message. Now, for those who don't receive the message and have doubt and skepticism and cynicism, I'll plant that seed into the garden of their mind. They'll reject the seed, and the seed doesn't grow. It grows on a rock. I mean, it's on a rock. Therefore, it didn't go into the soil, which means it's not going to grow. That's where, you know, the biblical principles talk about the adversary. That's the ego blocking the message, blocking the light. Okay, I'm not going to get into all this type of stuff. My point is, if you're not willing to receive, you won't receive. Okay, now this whole conversation is about the law of gender and the law of attraction. So again, we went over this before. Let me pull it out so you have your reference. Now, if you didn't see this video, I suggest you go back to this. I'll link it in the video description. We talked about thoughts are things. You are, I'm going to brush over this because I don't have time to explain everything about everything we went over. So thoughts are things. You are the toll keeper at the toll booth. Let's just keep it simple. Thoughts are things. You're the toll keeper at the toll booth. You can choose who you let through and who you don't let through. Now, in short, every thought can go through, or you can block certain thoughts and reject them. That's what rejecting is. That's what polar opposites are. You can reject and repulse certain thoughts by claiming that you are the opposite of that frequency. We went over that in part one. So you need to go back and watch that video. So as thoughts enter your brain, you're the observer. Thoughts are things. You're observing thoughts. Okay, now as you observe this thought, you can direct its focus. That's what the law of attraction really is. It's saying that what is your belief system? What is your threshold to block certain thoughts and reject them, but accept certain thoughts and automatically send them to Vegas? If you remember our example, how can you always have the system in yourself to direct those thoughts to that place, to where you're nourishing a focus? That's what the law of attraction really is. It's not that things are going to magically come to you. It's that you're filtering out things that don't matter, and you have a defined chief aim. Once you have this chief aim, you are sending all this positive thought, or whatever assuming you're accepting positive thoughts only, you're sending those positive thoughts to that destination in your brain or your focus, whatever it may be. And that, in this case, was point A, or Vegas. Now, I need you to go back to that video because I explain it way, in much more depth in that video. That's what I believe the law of attraction is speaking on. In that case, you're receiving or being the feminine energy to things which are giving to you. Okay, you're receiving those so that you can give them to that chief aim. So that's how you are attracting, so to speak. And that's the law of attraction. You have to become the receiver. Remember, your brain and you are a transmitter. They can give signal and receive signal. If you're not receiving the things that you need to build up your focus or your chief aim, you can't build a house without the bricks you need to build the house. You can't build a house without the cement. I don't know what house materials are. You need the wood for your house. You need the cement. You need the bricks if you have a brick front house. You need the... what else is in a home? I'm looking around. You need I don't know the materials. The point I'm trying to make is that you have to receive the resources in order to create whatever you're trying to create. And again, the key word is create. That doesn't mean just sit around and receive stuff and never do anything. What good is a bunch of wood sitting out front and a bunch of cement and a bunch of clay? I mean, whatever they use to build houses, cement. And what did I say? Bricks, wood, and cement. What good is a bunch of bricks, wood, and cement out in my front yard? Without a house, you need a blueprint for the house, and you need to start putting that house together. Now, you as an observer can accept those resources. That's the whole receiving portion of the toll booth of your mind. But you're just receiving. You're not doing anything. And that's the mistake a lot of people are making. They're just receiving all the raw materials, and they're like, okay, let's say you want to make a cake. You're like, okay, I got the flour. Somebody gave me some flour. Somebody gave me some eggs. Somebody gave me some oil. I don't know the ingredients of cake. And eggs. I think I said eggs. But you have all the material and you're like, okay, I got cake. No. You have to learn how to make the cake. You have to have a blueprint on what the cake's going to look like. And you have to put those materials to use by creating a process to create the result. That's the law of attraction. Okay. And that's where people are making the mistake. It's not some magical thing where like you think of something and it just becomes like a lot of people think you can just manifest by thinking. And what that means is a lot of people think you can just think that you're in a Ferrari and then magically you're in a Ferrari. The Ferrari thinking portion is the blueprint. Now you're going to receive the resources, the opportunities, the materials you need, the relationships you need. Now use those resources and create you being in that Ferrari. And that's the mistake people are making with the law of attraction. So I'll end it here. That's the biggest point. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. This is the Giving Game series right here at BusyWorksBeats. Well, let me move my cam. Right here at BusyWorksBeats.com.